What has life been like after Game of Thrones, particularly now that you're no longer involved in the show?
Oh, I'll take this one first. Game of Thrones has completely changed my life and has completely changed my career. And I will be forever grateful to David and Dan for doing that for me. I am getting into rooms now, I'm getting jobs now that I wouldn't have had a chance of 5 years ago. It has completely upped my profile and it's a calling card. If you walk into an audition room and the director and the producer look and say, 5 seasons of Game of Thrones, well, he can act. Now, is he right for the role? I don't know, but he can act because he was in 5 seasons of Game of Thrones. So it has been a phenomenal experience for me. It was awful to leave it. It broke my heart. I miss it terribly. I miss it dreadfully because when you're filming, you're a part of this incredible family. And it is. It's like an incredibly large, incredible, wonderful family. Everybody knows each other. Everybody does their job so incredibly well. From the person at the base of the pyramid to the person at the top of the pyramid. It's why the show is so good. It has transformed my life. And I'm grateful.
Yeah, I would agree with that. Definitely, it's a calling card compared with whatever else you might have done before, simply because it's universally known and universally appreciated. So, you know, other than that, everything else has happened chance. You know, it as you say, it opens doors and the rest is up to you, you know.
I agree. I mean, it just, those words sum it up.
Yes, they do. I remember being very, very sad for the last day's filming. I was with Roger and we both went. Because it became an annual event. We used to go to Belfast.
It did. That was the thing.
And suddenly we didn't have to go to Belfast anymore.
There was a sort of seasonal routine to it, yeah, wasn't there? I remember arriving, and the first thing I would do without fail was I would listen to I Will Wait by Mumford & Sons. That was the song I associated with arriving back into Belfast City Airport.
Really?
And when I drove back there, I just finished a film called The Lodgers on Friday, and when I drove back through Belfast to get home from Donegal, I put on the song.
I have to say, as a native of Belfast, it's awfully refreshing to hear people say, "I can't wait to go to Belfast." Well, you didn't used to hear that, let me tell you.
It has been very good for Belfast.
It has been
much more of a cachet than it ever would have had.
Mm. It really has. It has changed Northern Ireland's economy. It has made Northern Ireland a centre of filmmaking. Mm. It has given us a new tourist industry that I would have to say, and I can say this because I come from Belfast, that is not associated with a disaster of one sort or another. It has done absolute wonders for our province and the economy and all the crew and plasters, electricians, hotels, restaurants, you name it, the trickle-down effect has been stunning and seismic.
And another thing, though, about just sort of the life of an actor, the great thing about a series like Game of Thrones, especially if you know that you're going to be in it for a while, is that we're all freelancers. So at the end of the day, you finish your job, where's the next one? You know?
Mm.
The great thing about doing something like that is it's a banker. For a few years at least, you can say, if nothing else, I know I'm doing that next year. That takes the pressure off next year a little
bit. Yeah, it does.
Everything else then is a bonus because you know you've got that.
Yeah.
But whenever that is gone, well, then you're back to what's out there.
You're back in the pool.
But having said that, the way our industry is now, the way the entertainment profession is now, Game of Thrones is a gift that keeps on giving. Here we are at a Comic-Con meeting the fans, you know, and we travel the world, we go to Comic-Cons, and it's just wonderful. Yeah.
We should give a shout-out, actually. Comic-Cons are such fun to do. For anyone watching this, you really should come along to them. They're the place where you can be yourself most in the world. They are, the people are, without fail, absolutely lovely. They're joyous, and, they're just a wonderful, wonderful bit of modern popular culture, and I recommend them to everyone.
Brilliant. We've had a great time with, you know, over the last few years of the Comic-Cons, we really have.
Again, we meet up.
And
that's lovely as well.
It's like an old pals reunion for us.
I mean, which was even nicer is Ian and I never worked with each other on set.
Yeah.
There's so many people that you don't work with on set, and you meet them at events like this. It's like, hey!
And I get to come back, and I get to be with Ian, and Ian. It's great. And there's even Ian White who's hanging around, so I get the three Ians. It's fantastic.
You have to be called Ian.
I was going to say Eugene, but no, another time. Yeah, exactly.